Hi everyone, welcome to another webisode of The Good Doctor on easyliving.com. Today I'm in the company of Dr. Humeira Badsha, and we're going to be talking about osteoporosis. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So for all of our viewers who don't know what osteoporosis is, can you explain and define?
Very easy. Osteoporosis basically means weak bones. And these weak bones have a higher chance of fracturing or breaking, even with mild degrees of trauma. So you really need to take care of your bones at an early age to prevent fractures and other complications.
Now, when you're young, you don't think that anything bad can happen
exactly.
to you. And predominantly, we miss all the cues in our body, in our health. What are some of the cues for osteoporosis?
Well, none of the cues would really develop at a young age, but we really build our peak bone density and peak bone mass when we're young adults, between the ages from the childhood right up to age 35. That's what's considered a young adult. And from 35 onwards, it's downhill as far as our bones are concerned. And for women, especially after menopause, their bones just get weaker and weaker, and nobody realizes this till they're about 55, 60, and they just slip on the floor, they stretch their wrist out, the wrist breaks, or they start progressively fracturing the bones in their vertebra, and then they have, you know, that hunchback deformity, and they start losing height and become shorter and shorter. But the worst consequence of osteoporosis, unrecognized, is when someone just slips and breaks their hip. Breaking a hip can be really disastrous, because once you break your hip, you get into a bed, you become bedbound, you can die fast. 20% of hip fractures result in death.
Really?
Within the first year. So osteoporosis is not a disease to take lightly.
When you say that from 35 it's downhill for the bones, are there any signs that we can feel or changes that happen in the
body? No,
we can say, you know what, this could be osteoporosis related, let me go get it checked out.
No, there's no signs usually, unless you're older and you start having a hunchback, losing height, or you just fell and you fractured your bone with an injury which should not normally have fractured someone else, your friend. So then you should get checked. But it's important to be cognizant of the fact that if you don't take care of your bones today, you're going to get osteoporosis tomorrow.
Okay, let's talk about that. What is involved in bone care, if you can put it that way?
Yes, exactly. So the most important thing is calcium intake. You know, if children are not drinking milk, if they're not consuming calcium-rich foods, and young adults are not drinking milk, women who are pregnant and breastfeeding and not consuming calcium, which a lot of people aren't these days, then you're going to get osteoporosis. So that's the first step, is getting enough calcium in. The second step is getting enough exercise in. So if you're not doing both of these things, you're going to end up with weak bones, you see.
Okay. What about people who are lactose intolerant?
Right. So that's a big, big group of people now. Growing group of people who are lactose intolerant, or who think they're lactose intolerant, or for various reasons do not want to consume dairy or cow's milk products because of allergies. There's a whole group of thinking that says that milk is bad for you. So in that case, if you're not consuming milk, there are other sources of calcium. For example, green leafy vegetables, especially not overcooked, a little bit undercooked. The darker the green and the rawer the vegetable, the calcium is better absorbed in your system.
Brilliant. Well, that's good advice right there. Any other thoughts, comments on this issue that viewers should know?
So in a different episode, we're going to be talking about the importance of vitamin D for our bones. And without vitamin D, you cannot really absorb the calcium you consume from your gut. However, I wanted to mention that women after a certain age and men after a certain age must get a test called a bone density test. It's a specific test. It's an X-ray. It's simple to get, and it's a bone density test. So usually women after menopause, men when they're approaching 70, because men get osteoporosis a bit later, should have this test done.
Well, thank you very much for this insightful information.
Thank you.
For all of our viewers, if you've got any thoughts, comments, or questions about osteoporosis and this discussion that we had, please leave them in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching The Good Doctor on easyliving.com, where you can find anything and everything lifestyle.